get ready for Mike's Night at the Fights.
Here with Chip Perez. Second bout from last. Fans were actually snoozing out there tonight.
Yeah, man.
All of a sudden you come in against Mr. Tyson from Rochester, New York.
Yep.
Man put on the show of the night.
Yeah, man, he was tough. He was tough, but we trained 6 weeks hard. We were actually gonna fight Danny Valley, and he had gotten injured. So they pulled this kid in like the last week. So he came off a week's notice. So it was good though. I mean, I'm glad we prepared the way we did, because if we would have took him lightly, it would have came, you know, it would have been a lot worse.
Toe to toe action, nonstop, sitting ringside. Neither one of you showed any signs of giving up.
No.
Tell us, this is only your 7th pro fight. Am I correct?
My 8th.
Your 8th pro fight with only one loss.
Yeah, that
questionable loss.
DQ.
Exactly, questionable loss.
Yeah.
Digging deep for a fight such as this, where you have to actually show resiliency beyond belief.
Yeah.
Tell us what was going through your mind at that point when you knew you had somebody in front of you who's pressing up against you.
He's
not going nowhere. What do you do?
Heart. I know I have way more heart than him. I come in here, like, I didn't come to lose. So no matter what he brought, I was gonna bring more. Like, we train, we spar, then we train afterwards. Like, usually people spar and then jump rope and they're done. We train after we spar, you know, like, that's what we work for. We work to fight all 6 rounds, 8, whatever we're gonna fight. We train for it. You know, we don't train just for a fight, we train for war. And it's obvious that we had a war today, and I came out victorious.
Well, Chip, you're obviously not being pampered. They're putting opposition in front of you that is, to say the least, tough. But,
yeah.
I mean, where do we go from here now? It seems like an experience like this could probably catapult you to a whole different level of your career, where you could probably, you've showed tonight that you can successfully go out and fight some opposition that's maybe 10, 15 pro fights. Are you ready for that?
I mean, I leave it up to my team. My manager, you know, I trust my team. My job is to train and then fight. You know, like, I trust my trainer, my father, you know, the cut man, my cut man Dave, my manager Brett. Like, I leave it up to them. All I do is train, come and fight, and do what we did tonight, win.
Well, put on a masterful performance tonight.
Thank you.
And again, it's wonderful to see young guys such as yourself in a competitive fight and give the fans what they wanted to see. And we wish you a lot of luck in the future.
Thank you.
You want to give a shout out to anybody at this point?
I want to give a shout out to my team, first of all, to Ross, Dave, my dad, my manager Brett, for putting up with me for every day in the gym, good days, bad days. My family at home, my girlfriend that deals with, she's the best sparring partner I probably have. Like, I just, my family, my fans, they're all out there. As you can see, they cheered me on, you know, throughout the fight. I want to give a big shout out to all of them, because without them, you know, I wouldn't obviously be where I am right now.
Chip, one question I do want to ask you before we bring this interview to a conclusion.
Yep.
I saw you in the round, I believe it was the 5th round.
Yep.
And there was a amazing exchange between the two of you where it just, you guys threw caution to the wind, and just anybody could have got caught, let's put it that way. And I saw you look to the fans, and you gave, it almost looked like Russell Crowe in Gladiators, grinning to his people. What rush do you get looking at your fans? And I saw the scream that you gave to the crowd. Does it bring you, what I say, excitement? Does it bring more?
I love the brighter the lights, the louder the crowd, the more excited I get. I don't fold under pressure.
What goes through your soul, though? Tell me, what was that feeling at the ending of that round?
You know what? I can't even explain it. It came out of nowhere. You know, like, I felt tired, and all of a sudden I hear the crowd, and I see Ross coming up, my dad coming up, all amped. So I get amped. You know, like, it's just, they feed me the fuel. You know, like, they just put fuel in the fire. So that's all, you know.
Bottom line is, you keep giving the fans fights like those, you're going to go places.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Congratulations, Chip.
swept the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot, check the style. I flip the script so it can't get filed. At least not now, it'll take a while. I change the pace to complete the beat. I drop the bass to MCs get weak. For every word they trace is a scar they keep. It's when I speak, they freak to sweat the technique. I made my debut in 86 with a melody and a president's mix. And now I stay on target and refuse to miss. And I still make hits for beats, parties, clubs, and cars and jeeps. My underground sound vibrates the streets. MCs wanna beef, then I play for keeps. When they sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Know how many rhymes have I ripped and wrecked, but research has never found all the pieces yet. Scientists try to solve the context, philosophers are wondering what's next. Pieces took the lab to observe them, they couldn't absorb them, they didn't deserve them. My ideas are only for the audience ears, for my opponents it might take years. Pencils and pens and scores, letters put together from a key to cause. I'm also a sculpture, born with structure, because of my culture I'm a perfect instructor. Style that'll be full of technology, complete sights and new heights after I get deep. You don't have to speak, just see and peep the technique. But don't sweat the technique. I speak in the street, cause talk is cheap. Then I get deep in the beat, then complete. Pulled with the seat, never weak or obsolete. They never grow old, techniques become antiques. Better than something brand new, cause it's original. In a while, style I have much more value. Classical, too intelligent to be radical. Masterful, never irrelevant, mathematical. Here's some soothing souvenirs for all the years. And for the sort of thoughts and ideas. It's cool when you freak to the beat, but don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique. We'll be right back.
rapping. But I can't dig that backstabbing. Don't do me!